Emily Hayes still gets emotional when she comes home, or rather where her Sunset Hills house used to be. They got flooded out.
This was our home, and we had no help from the city. It was really hard. It still is.
She says her family didn't really know all the dangers they faced when they bought and rehabbed the house in the Sunset Hills floodplain. No one at City Hall warned them. In 2015, a flood forced them out. She never went back. By 2017, the house was torn down. Hayes was angry at Sunset Hills for giving the Winter Brothers the okay to bring in 57,000 cubic yards of dirt to their land in the floodplain. They hope it will eventually be an industrial court, something residents fear will lead to greater flooding, even though the company denies it. The deal was okayed by the mayor's administration and didn't need Board of Aldermen approval. But after the public firestorm, the mayor now says they're working on tougher legislation.
I think it's a really good thing. I just think it's kind of late in the game for these residents, not only Sunset Hills, but the Fenton residents, as this development's going to affect them as well.
I talked to Sunset Hills Mayor Pat Freebus about the city's new direction.
So do you wish there had been more scrutiny on that project?
That would have been a good choice, and we are certainly learning from it.
Sunset Hills' new legislation will require any development to remove the same amount of fill as they bring into a site in the floodplain. And the project would require approval from the Board of Aldermen. Sunset Hills now calling on other communities to join in.
Make stricter rules of developing in the floodplain and see if they will follow suit.
Which communities are you going to be calling on?
I'll be calling Arnold, Fenton, Wildwood, Eureka.
You're going to recommend they do more, essentially.
Yes.
But the dangers posed by the Merrimack River is on the minds of many communities. I talked to the mayor of Fenton today. He said they have their own approach to dealing with the problem. They don't think they need to beef up their laws. Fenton Mayor Bob Brasher says they've been buying property in the floodplains and keeping an extra close eye on any proposed development. But
under Fenton law, those projects are not required to go to the Board of Aldermen.
They are required in most cases. Manager,
we had just
about
talked
that
to your people, and they had said under Fenton's law, there's no requirement that these floodplain projects go to the Board of Aldermen.
That's true, according to the laws, but would it? Absolutely.
Fenton residents like Erica Hoffman think Fenton does need changes, just like Sunset Hills.
If Sunset Hills does it and Fenton doesn't, then it's just going to allow for that abuse to continue and putting those lives at risk.